Man, look, I'm at the crib thinking to myself, like, whoever made that meme talking about some forget being shot, have you ever woo woo woo? Ain't never been shot before, period. This is not the wave, yeah? I had to get my mind off it, so I picked up my phone and went into TikTok. I hadn't posted on my TikTok in a while, so I knew I had to go cool one time for the fun time. I knew that I was special back when I was breaking in houses and robbing and stealing. Every time I tried to be great, my little bullet wound was there to bring me right back to reality. Only God knows how long it'll take for me to heal, so I just went in the kitchen and grabbed me something to eat. I hadn't really had an appetite for real, but I was hungry today. Right before I was finna do these Oreos dirty, my OG came in the kitchen like, Brazil Marie, where are my cigarettes? Caught me off guard, shit.
Ma'am, that question wasn't rhetorical.
I don't know. Shit, you already got a little hole in your chest. I'm about to stumble on your tail.
Where are my cigarettes?
Hey, you gotta know when to hold them and when to fold them. I proceeded to walk to the refrigerator where I hid them. I took them out and handed them over. Shit.
Right. Don't play with me. And walked off.
I was just trying to save her life whole time. I heard somebody knocking at the door. My OG going to open it. She's standing there looking befuddled. Some man was like,
hi there, ma'am. I'm Detective Ross. I just wanted to say I'm sorry to hear about what happened to your daughter. I wanted to come by and ask a few questions to see if I could find justice for you and your family.
My OG, oh, okay, come on. She probably thought he was from DCFS at first. I mean, he did dress and look just like him all the time. It wasn't them this time, though. My OG went to go put her square out, and then she was like, Brazil Marie, come in here. I get up, walk into the front room, and the man was like, hey, little lady, you mind if I ask you a few questions?
Okay.
And then me and my OG went to go sit down on the couch.
Did you by chance get a look at the person's face who shot you that day?
Not really. Everything happened so fast.
Now, if you could think really hard,
can you remember anything that might have stood out that day?
Well,
I remember getting out of the car to go to the store, and then, next thing you know, somebody just started blinking.
Blinking?
My OG flicked me like, talk like you got some sense.
That means shooting, sir.
Okay, well, little lady, I'm going to do everything in my power to find out who was blinking at you.
Okay. Thank you,
Pete. By any chance, is her brother available so I can ask him a few questions?
He's not here. He's downtown with his friends playing ball.
But I can write the address down for you. Give me a second.
My OG went and got a piece of paper, wrote it down, and gave it to the detective. He
appreciates your cooperation. Sure, we'll get to the bottom of this very soon.
Well, thank you very much. I appreciate you.
He just nodded and walked off. I know my brother. He wasn't going to be too happy about seeing him. After he left, my mama went in the kitchen, went in the refrigerator, and said, that boy just eat up everything. Come on, Brazuma, we got to go to the store. I used to love going to the grocery store. It was just something about my refrigerator being full that did something to me. I dipped off into my favorite area, the candy aisle. While I was catching up with my favorite confections, my OG came around the corner like, Brazil Marie. Startled me,
What'd I tell you about wandering off?
Just like your daddy, can't never get you to stay close to me. Let's go.
I just couldn't stay out of trouble today.
We finally get to checkout. I hop in the line like, we can get in this line, mommy.
No, we're getting in this line, baby.
I look around like, but this line's shorter.
No, but this line is cheaper.
But everything costs the same price no matter what.
You too young to understand, baby. Just come on.
It made no sense to me at all. I guess it wasn't meant to.
Okay.
My friend popped out like, Brazil Marie.
She tried to give me a hug, but because of my bullet wound, I pushed her away. She,
what's wrong with you? I knew you was phony. We not friends no more.
I, baby girl, we were never friends in the first place. Outside of you giving me your chocolate milks, we have no other business.
She tried to swing my OG. You don't want to do that, little girl.
Her OG coming around the corner like, oh, hecky no. You can get your hands off my chat. My OG like, if you think I'm going to let your little overgrown baby pound on this one, you got me expletive. She overgrown. That's going to be the last name you call my baby. My, hey, Miss Ma'am, I don't want to talk. Period. And squared up. She say less. Well, that escalated quickly.
Ain't nothing funny but the videos. Motherfuckers wanna see me 6 feet before I even see my pinnacle. It's nothing less than critical. And now I gotta navigate with sentinels. In the same city that I glorify and try to organize, I identify the fake love with a poor disguise. Then they wonder why it's a poor connection.